India's independence was fought in 1947 by lawyers, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, etc., etc. You all know. Seventy years after India's independence, time has come to fight for another independence. And again, in this fight for independence of, we have achieved political independence. But now what is under very serious threat is the independence of India's democracy itself. And that is the independence of the judiciary. You see, the press conference of the four judges of the highest court of the largest democracy in the country, and judges of unimpeachable integrity. As we all know in the bar, whether 2, 3, 4, 5 are 100% honest or not, we know it. When they raise an issue before the country, and when the next incumbent, expected Chief Justice, makes a statement, we are discharging a debt of obligation to the nation so that the posterity does not allege us that we sold our souls. I think this is the biggest threat of India's democracy. And this bar has to remain eternally vigilant. Within 99 working days from now, today we are on 23rd of March, and from the next working day, that is 26th of March to 1st of October, when the next incumbent takes oath, we have got just 99 working days. We have to remain eternally vigilant whether or not there will be supersession of the judges. And this is a real threat confronting the nation. We all know what happened when Justice A.N. Ray was made the Chief Justice, Justice Shelet, Grover and Hegde were superseded. We all know when Justice H.R. Khanna fought valiantly in that famous ADM Jabalpur case into 4-1, when the constitution was defaced and defiled, four judges cavely tamed in to the might of the political power in view of the proclamation made by the emergency such and such, such and such, we hereby order that any petition under Article 226 under any circumstances, this, that, and under whether malafide, this will not maintainable. Writ petition not maintainable. Four judges on habeas corpus, and two of them then became the Chief Justices of India, Justice Chandrachur and Justice Bhagavati. That real threat is staring us in the face. The bar all over the country must stand solidly united that if on 2nd or 3rd of October, if any such eventuality comes, come what may, we shall not allow that to happen. We shall campaign from door to door. 16 lakh lawyers in the country must unite and prove to the powers that be what the collective lawyers, as the very name suggests, lawyers collective, can say. I feel this is the biggest threat that is confronting the nation. And politicians are united, make no mistake about it. whether this is this party or that party, all politicians are united to checkmate the judiciary. Who wants a strong and independent judiciary? Have you seen the retrospective amendment of 40 years? Have you seen the retrospective amendment of 40 years passed in the parliament a few days back without a single debate? FCRA legitimized by Congress and BJP both retrospectively for 40 years? Vedanta made a contribution, legitimized. So this is the only instance. In fact, I am unable to agree with my learned distinguished colleague. Mr. Manan is a very dear friend, one of the tallest members of the bar. You see, collegium system, I was a petitioner number two in person. Petitioner number one was Mr. Manohar Lal Sharma. And against heavy odds, I stood for 32 days during summer vacation of 2015. Collegium system may not have worked satisfactorily, but it is far better than hijacking the judiciary and checkmating the judiciary. Today, so many files are stuck. Mr. Manish Shibbad, as Madam Jai Singh has stated, will tell us. The judiciary is being crippled. And judiciary is the last bastion of hope of the people. So, time has come for the entire lawyers community, the entire bar, to sink their differences. Come what may, we shall not allow supersession of any judge. And this is a real danger. This is a real danger, mind you, ladies and gentlemen. This is a real danger which is not being talked about. 99 working days from hence, the clock has started ticking. Who will be the, whether or not the senior most judge of the Supreme Court will be the Chief Justice? Whether it will be a repeat of Supersessor of Justice Khanna, whether it will be a repeat of Justice Shelat, Grover and Hegde, we have to remain eternally vigilant. We shall not allow that to happen, come what may. So, therefore, the fight must go on. I won't take time. And in that fight, I will end up with one poem which I learnt in my school in Sardar Patel Vidyalaya. When the things go wrong, things are of course going wrong, as they sometimes will, and when the road you are trudging seems all uphill, when the funds are low and the debts are high, and you want to smile but you have to sigh, when care is pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you quit. Life is square with its twists and turns, as every one of us sometimes learns. And many a fellow turns about when he might have won, had he stuck it out. Don't give up, though the pace seems slow, you may succeed with another blow. Often the goal is nearer than it seems to a faint and faltering man. Often the struggler has given up when he might have captured the victor's cup. And he learned too late when the night came down how close he was to the golden crown. Success is failure turned inside out, the silver tints of the clouds of doubt. And you never can tell how close you are. It may be near to you when it seems. So stick to the fight. When you're hardest hit, it is when things seem worse that you must not quit. You must not quit, my dear brothers and sisters lawyers. Thank you.